In the early 70s, I was living in an apartment in Providence, right across the street from a building where my brother was working. And every now and then, we'd go out for lunch together. And one day, we went out for lunch. It was in August. It was a hot August day, and I was driving. We had lunch, and we were driving back to where I lived and where he worked. And as we were driving up the street, riding down the street on a bicycle that was way, way too small for him, was this guy who was huge. He was huge. He didn't have a shirt on. All he had on was muscles. He had muscles on top of muscles. He had muscles where most of us don't even have places. He was huge. He was so big, he'd make King Kong apologize. That's how big he was. And he's riding down the street. I said to my brother, "Allie, look at the size of this guy." And as he rode by us, he blocked out the sun. We were in the shade. I said, "Wow." We continued driving until we came to a parking lot. It was a community parking lot. I pulled into that lot and I looked, and right there in the middle of the parking lot was a car. And its four doors were open. And there were people sitting in the car. And the people in the car, they just had their lunch. And I could tell they just had their lunch because everything they didn't eat was on the ground outside the car. There were potato chip bags, soda cans, McDonald's boxes, Dunkin' Donut boxes, banana peels, all this trash. I said, "No way, no way. They're going to clean this mess up. I live here. They don't live here. They're going to clean this mess up." So I parked the car. My brother and I, we get out of the car, we start walking across the parking lot, feeling like a couple of gladiators. When all of a sudden, I stop. Because I notice from the corner of my eye, I notice that fellow with all the muscles. He rides that bike back into the parking lot, gets off the bike, and gives it to a little boy whose bike it was. And that fellow with all the muscles, he walked across the parking lot, over to that car, and he sits down in the driver's seat. It's his car. Those are his friends. It's their trash. Right away, I stop. I had to reevaluate the situation. I said to my brother, "Allie, you know, it doesn't look that bad." And it didn't. It didn't look that bad. I said, "I could always clean it up myself. No problem. Come on, let's go." And I thought my brother agreed with me as we walked across the street and we stood on the curb on the other side of the street. We stood there and we watched and we listened as all the doors of that car closed at once. Vroom! And that fellow with all the muscles, he put one hand on the steering wheel, dropped his other arm out the window of the car. His arm was so long, it touched the ground. He kicked out of the car with a little nudge. His knuckles were dragging on the ground, sparks coming from his jewelry. He pulled out of the parking lot, out into the street. He started to drive by us. I was standing there with my mouth wide open. And he started to drive by us when all of a sudden, I heard my brother's voice. My brother said, "Excuse me, excuse me." My heart went, bing. "Excuse me." The fellow driving the car looks at us, reaches back, pinches the rear tire of the car. My brother says, "Excuse me, can we have that stuff over there? You know, the banana peels, the soda cans, McDonald's boxes, Dunkin' Donut boxes. Can we have all that stuff?" The guy looks at us, looks at all that trash, looks back at us, reaches over, and he grabs the shift. I'm praying that he's going to put it in reverse and not park. He put it in reverse. He released the rear tire of the car. The car rolled back down the street. He turned it into that parking lot, right into the center of all that trash. He pinched the rear tire. He gets out of the car. He orders his friends out of the car. He points and they pick. He points and they pick. They're as afraid of him as I am. They pick up all their trash, plus trash that had been there for 6 weeks, and they put it in a big dumpster. They get back into the car. The doors all close. Boom! He puts one hand on the steering wheel, drops his other arm out the window of the car. His arm is so long, it touches the ground. He kickstarts the car. once again with a little nudge. His knuckles are dragging on the ground, sparks coming from his jewelry. He pulls out of the parking lot, out into the street. He starts to drive by us. I'm standing there with my mouth wide open. He looks at us, raises his arm up into the air, gives us the power salute with a big smile on his face, and he drives down the street. I can't believe it. My brother, he nudges me and says, "Len, it's not what you say, it's how you say it. Tact."